clubs, you know, take classes if you're interested in something. That's something that I've always done along the way, just thought, oh, I kind of want to know more about that, or I want to be better at that, and take that class, you know, find a local class and take it. Those are probably the two biggest things I would tell them.
What do you not do? Because that list might be shorter.
Let's see, what don't I do? A lot of things.
Build a sailboat, you go diving.
Yeah.
What's one question you haven't been asked in the last 24 hours?
I don't know, I haven't been asked it.
What's the answer? See, you haven't laughed this much so far.
Yeah, that's true.
What are your goals in NASA?
Just to be a good team member and learn as much as I can. Learn from the people that I'm working with and you know, do well with all of the opportunities that I'm given in training.
How long a process has this been to get from application to here?
About a year and a half. We submitted applications in the winter of last year. Then came down for the initial round of interviews in September and the second round of interviews over the course of the spring. So it's been a long process.
How did you find out?
A phone call.
And? How did that go?
I'd been waiting all morning for it, just continuing to check my phone over and over again while I was at work. And it actually came through when I walked home for lunch and was just sitting there. I just finished lunch. And suddenly my phone rang, and it was Johnson Space Center. And I think my initial reaction was, oh my God, it's Johnson Space Center, because I recognized the first six digits of the phone number. And I gotta answer this. And so I picked up the phone, and I was a couple members of the selection board, and they asked if I wanted to come down and join the new astronaut class for a little bit of small talk that lasted forever. And then I got off the phone and immediately called my mom and then everybody else in my family and told them about it.
And your parents still live in
Sugarland? Yep.
You're the pride of Sugarland now. Do you realize this? If the mayor hasn't called with a key to the city, it will happen.
Not yet.
Has the gravity of this whole thing hit you yet?
Starting to. Since coming down here, really, and just being back on the Space Center, kind of realizing that life is about to change pretty incredibly.
And you report in August?
Yes. Our first day is August 21st.
How do you describe all of this?
All of just the whole...
Every bit of it.
I don't think I've stopped smiling. And just kind of like a dream. It's something I've been thinking about for a really long time. It's always in the back of your head. You're going off and doing all of these things that you're also really excited about. Are really interested in, and then all of a sudden everything changes, and suddenly you kind of know what you're going to be doing for the next couple years, and it's a pretty incredible feeling. I'm really honored.
Where did you go to middle school?
First Colony.
First Colony. Anything else I didn't ask that you wanted to say?
Not really, just that I'm really excited to be coming down here in August, and really excited to work with the new class. Known them for a couple days now, but they are all incredible people. I'm really grateful, I guess, for the whole experience of going through just the whole selection process and everybody that I got to meet, both the support staff here, the other astronauts, but really the other interviewees, because everyone was just amazing. And really, like, I don't know how they even made the final decision, because just having spent a week or a week and a half with them, and then I guess finally I just want to thank my family and everybody that's helped me out along the way, because there's been a lot of people who had a major role and helped me, whether it was give me a chance, take a chance and give me a job, or help me during a tough time in school or at work, or give me some advice, or just teach me something new. They're all a part of this, so.
Thank you. What was your first job ever, you remember?
I worked in a running store. I was a lifeguard. Worked at Finish Line Sports in Sugarland, and then also lifeguarded out at Siena Plantation.
Think you learned something there that will help you?
The lifeguarding actually set me on a whole, that kind of kick-started an interest in emergency medicine, and I've gone on, done a wilderness first responder, and actually just got my EMT certification, and was planning to do some volunteering up on the Cape, so I'm hoping to still be able to do something along those lines down here, in all the free time that I'll probably have. So.